So today in this session we are going to discuss about the further types of losses in precious concrete. In the last session we discussed about the first loss, which is known as elastic deformation of concrete. Okay. So, and even we solved one problem in post tension system and pre tension system, how the loss takes place. Okay. So, in today's session, we are going to discuss the remaining losses. Okay. So, the next loss is loss due to shrinkage of concrete. Okay. So, again, this is an important loss. Okay. So, that is shrinkage of concrete. What? The loss, there is a loss in the stress due to shrinkage of concrete. So what is shrinkage again? So because of the temperature variation or because of the heat of hydration in the concrete will get shrinks. The concrete will get shrink. So because of that, what will happen? Loss will take place in precious concrete. Okay, that concrete try to reduce the prestress developed by the force which is acted through the cable. So the shrinkage of the concrete in prestress member results in a shortening of tensioned wires and hence contributes to the loss of stress. So what will happen? The shrinkage of concrete in prestress members results in shortening of tensioned wires. तो क्या करेगा, जब concrete shrink होगा तो that will force the cables to shorten. So because of that, what will happen? It contributes the loss of stress. अगर wire shrink होगा तो क्या होगा, it will contribute the loss of stress in concrete. So that we can calculate by using the equation, that is loss is equal to epsilon cs into es. So what is epsilon cs? Epsilon cs is nothing but shrinkage strain. And the value of that, you have to take it 300 into 10 to minus 6 for pretension members, if you are designing pretension member. And epsilon cs is equal to 200 into 10 to minus 6 divided by log of t plus 2. That is for post tension. So this you have to use for post tension. You have to use it for post tension members. And what is T here? What is T? So T is nothing but the age of concrete. Means what is the age of concrete? Because kya hota hai? Shrinkage of concrete is depend on what concrete kab cast kiya hai. So again the shrinkage of concrete will vary after 1 day, 2 day, after 1 day of placing of concrete, 2 day, 3 day, 4 day or so on. So we have to check the age of concrete. So how many days the concreting has been done. Okay. Then next is loss due to creep. So this is again important loss. Okay. So what is loss due to creep? So loss due to creep is the sustained prestress in concrete or constant deformation. This what is very important. Constant deformation in the concrete results in the creep of concrete, which effectively reduces the stresses in steel. So kya hota hai? As concrete ka life badhta hai, so it will undergoes creep. Okay. So creep is nothing but constant deformation. Concrete deform hota hai. Constant. There is a constant deformation in the concrete. So that deformation will ultimately affect the stress in concrete, which are going to develop by the tendons. Okay. So ultimately there will be loss due to creep. Okay. And for that, again, there is an equation. So that is loss due to creep is using creep coefficient. So we have the two methods here for the calculation of loss due to creep. So using creep coefficient we have. So first is loss is equal to m into fc into phi. So what is m here? M is nothing but modular ratio. m is animal modulus ratio, okay, which is given by m is equal to modulus of elasticity of steel divided by modulus of elasticity of concrete, correct? That is modulus of elasticity of steel divided by modulus of elasticity of concrete. Fc is again stress in concrete at level of steel, what you have calculated in the first loss, that is elastic deformation of concrete, same you have to use here. And phi is the creep coefficient. This is by using the creep coefficient. Then again we have using ultimate creep strain method. So equation for that, it is loss is equal to epsilon cs into fc into es. So again epsilon cs is ultimate creep strain which will be given, okay. Epsilon cs is the ultimate creep strain. Then fc is again what? Stress in concrete at level of steel, and es is modulus of elasticity of steel. So by using these two we can calculate what is the loss due to creep in the pre-stress, okay. The next is we have loss due to elastic loss due to relaxation of stress in steel. So this is again important, loss due to relaxation of steel. So this will happen generally in case of स्टील. तो क्या होता है, वी ट्राई टू जब टेंडन स्ट्रेच किया जाता है और टेंडन को टेंशन दिया जाता है, एंड व्हेन द टेंशन एंकर्ड दैट वेल देर विल बी लॉस इन स्टील बिकॉज ऑफ द रिलैक्सेशन, ओके, द स्टील विल गेट रिलैक्स दैट टाइम. सो ऑटोमेटिकली व्हाट विल हैपन, द लॉस विल बी देयर इन द टेंडन. सो अल्टीमेटली दैट इफ देर इज अ लॉस इन द टेंडन, सो ऑटोमेटिकली देर इज अ लॉस इन प्री स्ट्रेस. सो हम उसको कैसे कैलकुलेट करते हैं, सो दैट इज, दिस इज वेरी इजी. परसेंटेज ऑफ रिलैक्सेशन आपको मालूम होता है, डिवाइडेड बाई 100 इंटू द इनिशियल प्री स्ट्रेस. अगर इनिशियल प्री स्ट्रेस हमारा 100 है और परसेंटेज है 10%, तो कितना हुआ, सो 10 न्यूटन पर एम स्क्वायर. सो 100 में से 10 न्यूटन पर एम स्क्वायर लॉस हुआ हमारा, बिकॉज द 10% इज द रिलैक्सेशन. 100 में से 10% मतलब 10 न्यूटन पर एम स्क्वायर, ओके. सो द इनिशियल अगर 100 है, सो 10% मतलब 10 न्यूटन पर एम स्क्वायर लॉस हुआ, तो अल्टीमेटली हमको कितना मिला, द फाइनल स्ट्रेस इज 90 न्यूटन पर एम स्क्वायर. दैट इज बिकॉज ऑफ इफ देर इज अ रिलैक्सेशन ऑफ 10%. सो ऑन बेस्ड ऑन द परसेंटेज ऑफ रिलैक्सेशन यू हैव टू कैलकुलेट द लॉस, ओके. देन नेक्स्ट इज लॉस ड्यू टू एंकरेज स्लिप. सो दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, एंड यू हैव टू नोट हियर, दिस यू हैव टू यूज ओनली फॉर पोस्ट टेंशन ओनली, बिकॉज प्री टेंशन में हम एंकर यूज नहीं करते हैं, ओके. इन पोस्ट टेंशन वी हैव टू यूज द एंकरेज सिस्टम. व्हाई यू हैव टू यूज एंकरेज सिस्टम, बिकॉज इन पोस्ट टेंशन द केबल, बिकॉज इन पोस्ट टेंशन में क्या होता है, केबल रहता है, ओके, एंड दैट केबल विल बी पास थ्रू द डक्ट. दैट केबल, बिकॉज इट इज अ पोस्ट टेंशन, द केबल विल बी पास थ्रू द डक्ट एंड द केबल विल बी एंकर्ड एट द एंड्स. आर यू गेटिंग अ पॉइंट, व्हाई इट इज कॉल्ड एज पोस्ट टेंशन, द केबल विल बी पास थ्रू द कॉन्क्रीट थ्रू डक्ट, ओके. सो एंड दैट केबल इफ यू रिलीज इट विल कम बैक. सो उसको रिलीज नहीं करना है, सो वी हैव टू लॉक एट द एंड्स, वी हैव टू एंकर एट द एंड्स, ओके. सो बेसिकली द इम्पॉर्टेंट इज हियर, दिस लॉस विल अकर ओनली इन केस ऑफ पोस्ट टेंशन सिस्टम, ओके. सो दैट इक्वेशन इज अगेन डेल्टा इन टू ES बाई L. सो ये एंकरेज स्लिप कैसे होता है, ओके. सो एंकरेज स्लिप इज बेसिकली बिकॉज ऑफ द एंकरेज सिस्टम. जब केबल लॉक किया जाता है एट द एंड्स, तो क्या हुआ, ड्यूरिंग लॉकिंग सिस्टम बिकॉज ऑफ सम एरर और बिकॉज ऑफ सम कॉजेस, ओके, देर विल बी स्लिप ऑफ टेंडन फ्रॉम द एंकरेज. सो दैट टाइम व्हाट विल हैपन, अगर स्लिप हुआ तो क्या हुआ, वॉट एवर द टेंशन इज गिवन इन द केबल दैट विल नॉट बी देयर, बिकॉज स्लिप टेक्स प्लेस, सो द टेंशन इट विल लूज इट्स टेंसाइल कैपेसिटी. सो बिकॉज ऑफ दैट देर विल बी लॉस ड्यू टू स्लिप, ओके. सो दैट कैन बी कैलकुलेट बाई यूजिंग दिस, लॉस इज इक्वल टू डेल्टा इन टू ES बाई L. सो डेल्टा इज अमाउंट ऑफ स्लिप, L इज स्पैन, एंड ES इज मॉडुलस ऑफ इलास्टिसिटी ऑफ स्टील. सो डेल्टा इज वॉट इज द स्लिप टेकन प्लेस इन द एंकरेज स्लिप, ओके. नेक्स्ट इज अगेन इन केस ऑफ पोस्ट टेंशन सिस्टम, दैट इज लॉस ड्यू टू फ्रिक्शन, ओके. सो लॉस ड्यू टू फ्रिक्शन, सो अगेन इट इज इन पोस्ट टेंशन. तो क्या होता है इन पोस्ट टेंशन सिस्टम, सो वी नो दैट, क्या होता है पोस्ट टेंशन सिस्टम में, the again there is a conduit or a duct. We pass the cable into the duct, okay, and when you stretch the cable, so there will be loss or there will be friction into between the duct and the cable. Kya hota hai? When the cable is passed through the duct and when you stretch, to kya hota hai? There will be friction between the internal face of the duct and the cable. In the internal face of the duct and cable. So because of that, there will be friction. So automatically what will happen? Agar friction hua, so then there is a loss in cable or there is a loss in prestress. So this is the equation. The basic equation is Px is equal to P naught into A raised to minus mu alpha into Kx. So P naught is initial prestress here. Mu is coefficient of friction. K is wave effect, which is can take the values they are given for this. Then alpha is the angle of inclination. So wave effect means the cable, when you pass, the cable will be like this. And when it will get stretched, so that time it will develop friction. So that is the wave effect. Then alpha, the angle of inclination is according to the cable profile. Then distance is x. Okay. Then what they are given, for small values of mu alpha plus kx, we can write px is equal to p naught into 1 minus mu alpha plus kx. So the ultimately this term will be p naught minus, means p naught is the initial minus this loss. So this is because of loss and this is initial. So ultimately the loss is what? Loss is equal to p naught is equal to mu into alpha plus k into x. Mu into alpha plus k into x. So this is the loss. This is initial minus loss. So loss is p naught into mu alpha plus k into x. Okay. So the alpha, the value of alpha is depend upon the cable, how you tensioned it. Okay. So here I have the sketch. Okay. Here I have the sketch. So the value of alpha here, it is very important. So they have given two cases. What if alpha is nothing but the angle of inclination? Okay. So if for the cable profile, okay, if cable is pulled from one end, agar cable ek hi side se pull ho raha hai, the cable is pulled from only one side, and if the cable is pulled from both the ends, if the cable is pulled from both the ends, dekho yahan pe, from both the end we have the pulling system, here we have only one side pulling system. Okay. So that time the slope of alpha will vary. So that time the slope will be 4e by l, where e is the eccentricity and l is the span. So automatically slope is equal to 4e by l. Okay. Then alpha is equal to 2 times slope. So you have to take the value of alpha is equal to 2 times slope. Based on the given condition in the problem, you have to take alpha is equal to 2 times slope. Okay. Then if cable is pulled from both the ends, if the cable is pulled from both the ends, so that time you have to take alpha is equal to slope. That is equal to alpha is equal to directly slope. So what is slope here? 4e by l. Okay. Slope is 4e by l. Agar aap cable one side se pull karte ho, alpha is 2 times slope. Agar aap cable dono side se pull karte ho, alpha is equal to slope. Okay. And x is equal to l by 2. So this is important you have to take here while solution of problems, whether the cable is pulled on one side or both the side. Okay. So after this discussion, we'll have a solution or the we'll solve the small problems for the different types of losses in prestress concrete. So once again we'll discuss or we'll solve the problems in next session. Okay. Thank you.